The XL Coat Fire System is a fire retardant, waterproof deck and roof coating designed for surfaces exposed to pedestrian foot traffic. The system is composed of a latex-modified cementitious underlayment embedded into metal lath, a fiberglass mat reinforced waterproof membrane, texture, and top coats. The XL Coat Fire System is specifically designed to provide waterproof protection, lasting beauty, and a Class A 1-hour fire rating on a plywood substrate. The finished surface can be varied to achieve the desired texture and degree of skid resistance. The deck coating will not discolor, fade, break down, or deteriorate due to direct sun exposure. Water-based acrylic components ensure fast, reliable dry times. Each step of the process can receive same-day foot traffic, ideal for retrofit applications. The XL Coat Fire System is available in a large array of contemporary colors, with the option of two-tone color textures, patterns, stamps, and designs with clear seal coats. XL Coat waterproofing systems can be installed over other waterproofing systems. The following is a general application. Contact a UPI representative for project-specific details. Deck framing must be 16 inches on center. All plywood shall be a minimum of 5/8 of an inch thick. Exterior exposure 1, CDX or better, plugged and filled. Check all joints. All edges must be supported on framing and blocked. Plywood shall be fastened with deck screws or nailed with 10D ring shank or equivalent non-backing nails in accordance with local building code. Plywood must be sloped to drain 1/4 inch per foot. If the plywood is not properly sloped, sloping can be achieved with the XLcrete application. Acceptable forms of deck-to-wall flashing include combo diodo and two-piece weep screed. Metal flashing shall be galvanized or have a bonderized finish and be a minimum 26 gauge. Metal flashing shall be fastened 3 inches on center in a W pattern with galvanized flashing nails. Flashing must be nailed down flat with no buckling. Drip edge flashing is recommended for outside edge flashing. All metal flashing must have a minimum 3-inch overlap at the connecting seams. Corners must be tight and the entire perimeter must be flashed. All joints and seams shall be caulked with approved polyurethane sealant. The entire deck surface should be covered with the 2.5 galvanized metal lath. Lath shall be installed over the horizontal edge of all metal flashings. All seams in the lath shall be tight with no gaps or overlap. Using a 16 gauge minimum 1-inch crown and minimum 5/8-inch leg galvanized staple. Begin to staple in the middle of the sheet and work toward the edges. Staple in a checker pattern, using approximately 25 staples per square foot. After all sheets have been fastened, staple all seams at a rate of 1 staple per linear inch. Use galvanized roofing nails in any areas where the staple gun will not reach. Use a hammer to knock down any high spots in the staples and metal lath, as these may protrude from the preceding coat. With a drill motor and mixing attachment, mix 1 bag of XLcrete with 1 to 1.25 gallons of XLcrete additive. Continue mixing until both parts are thoroughly combined and a uniform consistency is achieved, approximately 2 minutes. Starting at the perimeter of the deck, apply XLcrete over the metal lath with a steel finishing trowel. Apply uniformly at 1/4 inch thickness while completely covering the metal lath. 1 bag of XLcrete should cover approximately 20 to 25 square feet. Once the XLcrete has been cured, the surface needs to be checked to ensure water slopes to drain. Any additional fill or sloping that is necessary shall be done before the application of the following coats. Additional fill or sloping may be achieved using XLcrete. Refer to the XLcrete data sheet and application guide for additional information. With a grinder, level out any imperfections or trowel marks in the XLcrete surface. Patch any minor imperfections with XL Coat patching compound or additional XLcrete. The fire system waterproof membrane consists of XL Coat number 1 and fiberglass mat. Cover deck surface with fiberglass mat. butt the edges of the fiberglass together, but do not overlap. Fiberglass should cover the edge of the flashing terminating 1/2 inch from outside edge. With a 4-inch brush, generously apply the material around the perimeter of the deck. It is essential that the material cover all the flashing of the walls and door jams. Saturate the fiberglass mat with XL coat number 1. With a 3/4-inch nap roller, apply XL coat number 1 at a rate of 50 square feet per gallon. Using moderate pressure, work puddle of XL coat number 1 into the fiberglass mat until thoroughly saturated. XL coat number 1 must completely penetrate through mat and into substrate. Any bubbles and wrinkles should be removed and repaired at this time. The fully cured surface should be completely saturated and have no uncoated areas of fiberglass. A skim coat of XL-crete is recommended for added longevity of the fire system. With a drill motor and mixing attachment, mix one bag of XL-crete with 1 to 1 1/4 gallons of XL-crete additive. Continue mixing until both parts are thoroughly combined and a uniform consistency is achieved, approximately 2 minutes. Apply XL-crete over the cured XL coat number 1 and fiberglass with a steel finishing trowel. Apply uniformly at about 1/8 inch thickness, completely covering the fiberglass. One bag of XL-crete should cover approximately 150 square feet. With a grinder, level out any imperfections or trowel marks in the XL-crete surface. Use a flat floor scraper to remove any remaining imperfections. Use a blower to clean the deck surface of any dirt or debris. With tape and paper, mask off walls, railings, and doors. There are many different texture options available. Most popular is the XL-crete KD knockdown texture. With a drill motor and a mixing attachment, mix one bag of XL-crete KD knockdown texture with 1 to 1 1/4 gallons of XL-crete additive. Continue mixing until both parts are thoroughly combined and a uniform consistency is achieved. Pour the XL-crete KD mix into a hopper gun. Starting with the perimeter of the deck, apply XL-crete KD texture at a rate of approximately 200 to 300 square feet per batch. Move the pistol as evenly as possible to create a uniform spray and texture. As the texture begins to set, use a steel trowel to knock down the desired texture. Spiked shoes are recommended while stepping into the texture. Prior practice is always recommended to make sure the hopper gun is set to the correct pressure. With a flat floor scraper, lightly scrape off any irregularities in the texture. Use a blower to clean the deck area of any remaining dirt or debris. XL coat number 300 is available in a large variety of different contemporary colors. Thoroughly mix XL coat number 300. With a 4-inch brush, apply the first coat of XL coat 300 around the perimeter of the deck and drains. The material should cover all flashing at the walls, door jams, and fascia edges. Apply the first coat by roller at approximately 100 to 150 square feet per gallon. Spread rate will vary with degree of texture. Apply the second and final coat of XL coat number 300 at approximately 150 to 200 square feet per gallon, with long, even strokes, leaving no roller marks or excess material. The final result is a durable, decorative, and skid-resistant waterproofing system.